Dear student, assalamu alaikum. Today in 10th biology class, the topic is the mechanism of breathing. As we have studied, breathing is the physical movement associated with the gaseous exchange. Objectives. At the end of lesson, student will be able to define inspiration or inhalation and expiration or exhalation. And the steps involved in inspiration and expiration. Breathing is the process of inhaling air into lungs and exhaling is letting air out from lungs. There is a system of organs involved in the process. There are two phases of breathing, inhalation or inspiration, exhalation or expiration. The process of inspiration and expiration shows with the help of diagram. In inspiration, during inspiration, the ribs muscles contract and ribs are raised. Ribs muscles which are attached to the ribs, they will be contract and so the ribs will be raised. At the same time, the dome shaped diaphragm, the diaphragm which is dome shaped, but in inspiration it will be lowered. The dome-shaped diaphragm contract and is lowered. These movement of intercostal muscles and diaphragm increase the area of thoracic cavity. It increase the area. The pressure on lungs reduces. The air pressure reduce on lungs. So air from outside rushes into the lungs. To equalize the pressure on both sides, it is an active process. Because energy is spent in contraction of intercostal muscle and diaphragm. Now in expiration, after the exchange of gases in alveoli, the air which is rich in carbon dioxide is expelled out in exhalation. The wrist muscles, which are called intercostal muscles, relax, bringing the wrist back to original position. They come back to the original position. The diaphragm muscles relax and it gets its raised dome shape. Now the diaphragm relax and it's again its dome shape. It is the relaxed condition. The space in chest cavity reduces and it increases the pressure on lungs. The lungs contract and air is expelled out of lungs. Human breathe 16 to 20 times per minute in normal circumstances. During exercise or other hard physical work, the breathing rate may increase up to 30 to 40 times per minute. Comparison between the inspired and expired air. Amount of oxygen in atmosphere is 21%, so we inspire the air. The amount of oxygen will be 21% and in expired air, the amount of oxygen will be 16%. The amount of carbon dioxide in atmosphere is 0.04. So, in inspired air, the amount will be 0.04. But in expired air, amount of carbon dioxide will be 4%. Amount of nitrogen is 79% and in expired air also 79% because our body do not need nitrogen. Amount of water vapors variable in atmosphere. So in expired air, amount of water vapor will be variable, but in expired air it will be saturated. Amount of dust particles variable and in expired air almost none. Temperature of the environment is variable. So the inspired air, the temperature will be variable. But in expired air, almost equal to the body temperature. Home assignment. Write the comparison between the inspired and expired air. Write down the steps of inhalation and exhalation. Thank you.